Sometimes we don't go to school, we still know many more things than the people who had a very high diploma. Because the knowledge that we gain from this world is not complete. It's not complete. It's okay just to add two and two, make four, that's it. But for every other thing in the universe, we have to rely on our wisdom in order to know. For example, like when I told you about the 4 or 5 years' time, if we're not doing anything, then we'll be in trouble because the gas will be released from the ocean. And we will be poisoned. It will be in the air. So I already mentioned that. Because if only rising water, you can get a boat, you know, a yacht if you're rich, or build one like Noah, or go live in a mountain, etc., etc. Or go in the helicopter and wait, or have a helicopter that even park on the water. There are aeroplane and a helicopter which can land on water. Some people can afford it, and they may be able to kind of escape the danger of rising water. But not when we have poisonous gas in the air and all kind. And that was before I know about the scientists' discoveries, say, the year 2012. Now we have scientific evidence and support. So that's what it is. So that knowledge doesn't come from my school learning. No school have taught that. And I'm not like scientist per se that I sit there or I calculate all this weather forecast or I know about all the agriculture or the ocean gas. I don't have time also to sit there and calculate by mathematics and come to that conclusion. I just know that from insight. And then later on, it turns out that I was correct. And since we have the scientific back up, then we could go out to help, you know, disseminate this kind of information or go to help people. So I have to thank the scientists for this, because without their backup, I don't know if I can even tell you to go out to distribute flyers about the climate change and all that. Every time they predict something, it did not happen. But I'm telling you why it did not happen either. More enlightened people in the world, more vegetarian people, more compassion, more helping each other, more loving kindness in the world, then this is powerful. It keeps pushing the negative power away, away from the edge, away from harm. And so the more we are doing our program right now, like having Supreme Master Television, broadcasting all the constructive news, and the more you distribute the flyers, more people become vegetarian, then of course, the more stable the planet, weather and safety will be. That's what it is.
Hello, Master. In these 4 months, I have a lot of information that's come through me, the information about sound street vibration from different situations, like if we eat meat or if we are being mean to other people, we create low vibration to others. And I wrote it down, like, and it become like a little story.
Yes, experience, keep it to yourself. You can tell us one of the story because they're curious, but that's it.
Okay. I write it like in the beginning was the absolute, and in the absolute was nothing. So then from the absolute, there is spirale. From the spirale come out the light and the sound stream. And that was the first vibration. And everything in this universe is based on vibration because we are made from vibration.
But I told you that already at the time of initiation. What's new? Oh, but you realize it yourself.
Yeah,
okay,
yeah.
Cool.
It came out like a little story.
In picture?
In picture also in letter.
In English?
part in English, part in German, because my German is better than English.
Oh, so the universal power knows to write in German for you. Wow. How amazing. What an intelligent. Okay.
And anytime information can come out, I myself is surprised about this information, and I have fun with it.
Just one of those things that you should know and you would know. You know, as you practice along, the different information will come to you. Mm. Have fun with it.
Thank you. Yeah.
If you write book, maybe you won't have any more.
Yeah, I know.
Even I don't always tell everybody about everything. I tell just a little bit what necessary. For example, the communication with animals. I even thought, should I? Yeah, but to save the animals, I did it. In just a small portion, enough for the world to digest.
For me, it's very interesting.
Of course it is interesting.
Yeah.
Because it's not in this world what you know.
Anytime I write something down, I will have confirmation from other author, of also from your lecture.
These things, like the book or the story or the Bible experiences or the Bible script, they came also from other practitioners in the old time. And normally it wasn't for the public. He probably wrote it down just like you wrote down. And after you die, somebody maybe collect it and make it into the story, a Bible or something like that. That's why we know all the information from the old time. Like the Buddha disciple go to which level of heaven, and Jesus went to what heaven and what he knew, and Jesus disciple went to second heaven, hear the trumpet, see the light. I give you like diary, and you write out your experience for yourself so that you know how you progressed. And then if you die and somebody found it and, oh, she was a saint. My God, why didn't I know that? And then you become a saint. And maybe your story and her story, his story and all that become a big Bible in the future. That's how the Buddha became more known to this day. That's how Jesus or Prophet Muhammad or Guru Nanak, a Jainist religious leader, have become more known to the world because of the script. The experience has been written by disciples that has proved their greatness. Otherwise, without the disciples' experiences, nobody know what the Buddha is. How great can he be if nobody know what he did or how his disciple has become enlightened to what extent? Therefore, it's like that, yeah.
It was a pleasure to have you with us today for Between Master and Disciples. Please stay tuned for Animal World, Our Co-Inhabitants, up next right after Noteworthy News, here on Supreme Master Television. May Providence grace your life with tranquility and divine love.